I'm Wim Hof, the Iceman, as the way they call me. You all know me because of the records I did under the ice, on the Mount Everest, all in shorts and hanging by one finger.
No, I don't know you, but you kind of look like Colt of Dusty a bit. I don't know if that counts for anything.
In the winter time, at 1.5 kilometer, all kinds of challenges. Challenges because I investigate into life.
I want to get everything out of life, and I did. I found out we can do a lot more than we think.
So you investigate into life, whatever that means, because you do remarkable challenges.
And now I have come up with a natural method, the Wim Hof method, and then scientifically endorsed.
Hey, scientifically endorsed, cool.
Showing that we are able to go deeply within the autonomic nervous system.
He means autonomous, according to his website.
The autonomic nervous system, related to the immune system, could be a way to prevent from disease or to influence much more by sheer will of your own.
So he's claiming to boost the immune system through this revolutionary new technique, which is based on the idea of using your willpower, using proper balance within your body to bring about a greater immunity which can prevent you from getting disease, or at least be a massively contributing factor to avoiding disease.
Into your own physiology, much deeper than as thought possible, even scientifically. So I showed myself to be able to do that in a hospital, in a laboratory setting, in an environment controlled by doctors and professors, and it works.
The rest of the video is basically filler. There's the idea of changing your life, the way you live, and becoming stronger, more immune to different problems, able to deal with different conditions. But do you actually gain a greater immunity, or simply, well, look after yourself physically, what you take in, how you work out, being at peak physical fitness, and thus ensuring that you'll, of course, have a slightly better immunity? In a way, willpower is a factor, but only because, well, it's bound to be a factor if you're working out, if you're keeping yourself in shape, and if you're keeping yourself on certain types of food, especially if it's stuff that's speeding up your metabolism.
Because it's revolutionary, it's a Wim Hof method.
And what's the method? It's heavy breathing and body awareness. So he's claiming that by breathing heavily, in a way similar to certain types of yoga and meditation, you can increase your body's heat, you can increase your awareness of your body, and by doing this, you can prepare yourself for any conditions. It's hardly revolutionary. It's well-known ideas. I think probably the most disturbing part of the Vice documentary is where you've got a person who's suffering with cancer who's actually taken up this idea. He feels better, but really? You're just simply bullshitting yourself. I think the scientific test really only showed that an adrenal rush can cause an immune response. So that's to say, the effect of adrenaline upon his system, which he was able to influence to some degree at least. There's also the claim that you cannot change your heartbeat. If you get mugged on the street, your heart rate goes up, as it naturally would, but you can't simply increase it right now. But we know that people can control their heartbeat to some degree. This is an observed fact, not new science. There have also been people observed in scientific conditions who can have adrenal rushes, who can basically influence their metabolism through this process. Amateurs and professionals alike have been able to induce these states. A simplistic way of inducing hypothermia is a good example, but also people inducing these states through meditative practices. I don't think this practice, or the potentiality for certain types of medication, will really change the world. I don't think there'll be a revolution, but I think there are some interesting possibilities for future medication and practice for people suffering from certain serious conditions.